So I am unboxing with you Twitter's new dashboard. So this is my first time using it, and I'm going to go through it from the very beginning. So actually, let me click back, and this is the first thing you'll see. You're going to go to dashboard.twitter.com/landing. Then we're going to click Try Twitter Dashboard. Then it tells us to choose our kind of business. So I'm an online business with 2 to 5 employees. Now I'm going to click Next. All right, so it says learn what people are saying about your business. If you only monitor your mentions, you might be missing a lot of the conversation. We'll help you set up a custom feed to capture tweets you might otherwise miss. Okay, I'm intrigued. So I'm going to click Next. It says your custom feed automatically includes your business name and mentions. Now let's expand it to capture more tweets about your business. Add words or phrases connected to your business or choose from the related terms below. So it says, how do people talk about your business? Okay, so you could enter hashtags, unique names, phrases, people, and so forth. So I'm going to experiment with this. Okay, so I entered in some different things, a couple of hashtags, and it's showing me them in order of popularity. So now I'm going to click Next, and it says any terms you want to exclude are going to we put here. Okay, so like you're interested in photography, but not like lifestyle photography. I guess that's what we'd enter there. I can't think of anything right now. So now I'm just going to click Save Feed. So now it's saying respond to really positive mentions with a quote tweet. Say thanks and use an emoji. So a little bit of Twitter coaching there. Very smart on Twitter's part because they know people are a little bit lost when it comes to Twitter. So this is their effort, I guess, to simplify things a little bit. Okay, so this is interesting. In the first column right here, it says about you. So it's showing me tweets based on those keywords that I gave it. So right here, it's saying that, like, for example, I was looking at this and thinking, well, why is this showing up? But it says a good-looking group, but the kid in the middle of the front row can't be taller than blah, blah. Okay. So I had put front row in there. So I'm going to edit and take front row out because this is giving me a bunch of stuff that is not relevant. To do that, I think I click here on edit. That's exactly where we go. And now I'm going to delete some of these. I think I'm going to also add some things in there that I'm interested in seeing. So how about hashtag Snapchat tips? And maybe I'll do the same thing for Facebook tips. So yeah, that's given me exact, and you see that it showed up right away, a tweet, Facebook tips. All right, so let's click back on home again. All right, so that's home. So it's showing us this feed, and then we could see our tweets and our timeline. So our tweets are things that we've tweeted out, and then just like the regular Twitter feed, and then the timeline is showing us the people who were, and the timeline is just our general timeline of everybody who we're following. So I guess the unique factor here is this about you Twitter feed. If we click on create, we can schedule a tweet in advance, which of course we've always been able to do in Twitter ads, but they're just trying to make it more simple. So let me find a link to tweet. Okay, so I'm going to say, and then I think I'm going to include a little GIF, and we'll look for a Twitter one. Okay, so there's kind of a funny one. And now let's look at show calendar. So I'm going to schedule this. For about 30 minutes from now. So you can only schedule it out one time in advance. So for me, this would not replace Edgar. I probably wouldn't use this in this fashion, but I get where they're trying to go. Okay, then Now we're going to click analytics. And Twitter has always had really beautiful analytics, but it looks like they've even tried to make them just more simplified than they already were. So from last week, it's showing me how many tweets, how many replies, how many mentions, showing all my new followers. And that's nice because it's just very clean. Again, for me, I don't think this would replace any third-party apps that I'm using, but I think it's a pretty cool new feature. Okay, so now I'm clicking on my tweets, and this is a really nice overview. So it's showing how many impressions, and it's just showing you which ones did the best, which ones didn't perform so well. So I guess now what I'm curious about is how we access the dashboard from inside our main Twitter platform. And currently, I do not see it where I would expect to see it. So it looks to me that in order to access the dashboard, you actually have to just go to that URL. Similar to how when we want to use TweetDeck, we have to go to that URL. So we'll just keep our eye on that and see where it goes.